brothers who come and ask me the question. Brother Zakir, fine. Those people who have knowledge of Quran and Hadith, for them it is very easy to know what is right, what is wrong, what is Sahih Hadith, what is Sahih Hadith. How can we, as lay Muslims, as common Muslims, understand what is right, what is wrong? It's a very good question. I tell them. Then they say, that's the reason we do taqleed. I tell them, see, what is the meaning of taqleed? Taqleed means, see, following the opinion of any scholar does not make you in the format of taqleed, doesn't make you muqallid. If after showing proof that the scholar you are following is wrong and then you follow him, yet that makes you a muqallid. For example, if your mother has a heart problem, fine, has a heart problem, and some doctor, what will you do? Who will you go to? You won't go to Tom, Dick and Harry, you'll go to a heart specialist. You do research. MBBS? No. MD? MD. MD in what? In brain? No. Heart? Yes. So before going to a doctor, you do research. You check up what is his degree. MBBS? No. MD? Yes. MD in what? Gynecology? No. Kidney? No. Brain? No. Cardiologist? Yes. DM? Super speciality. MD of medicine, then you do super speciality DM. You do your research and then you go to him. You don't blindly follow any Tom, Dick and Harry. If anyone on the street says, your mother has a heart attack, okay, do this. Will you follow him? No. You will do research. Similarly, the third category, Atiullah, Atiur Rasul, obey Allah and obey the messenger. The third category, those endowed with knowledge or those charged with their affairs, you do research. Any scholar says anything, check up whether it's right or wrong. See, everything you cannot check up. Now you have heard 10 different scholars. You understand how scholar number A, he has given about 30-40 references. I have checked up 20. 20 Quran Sahih Hadith. So 21st you need not check. You check scholar number 2. Scholar number 2, mixture. Part correct, Sahih Hadith, part Zaif Hadith. Third scholar, majority, pulling fast ones. Sahih Hadith, it's not there. Bukhari, you open Bukhari, more than 7,000 hadith, you don't find it only. So you have many scholars, you do little research. Now once you make up mind, scholar number 1, when he talks, he gives references. When I checked up the references, Quran, Sahih Hadith. Then what happens? Then when you ask an opinion and 3 scholars give you the opinion, you automatically follow the first scholar. Because I've checked up 20 things of his, it has turned out to be right. Even the 21st inshallah will be right. So every layman cannot do research on everything everyone says. So first, but you have to limited research. This scholar number A, he speaks on Quran and Hadith. Scholar A, B, C, D, or scholar number 1. Scholar number 2, or scholar number B, partly right, partly wrong. Scholar number C, or scholar number 3, majority wrong. So you do little research and classify which type of a scholar is he. And then if you follow without doing research scholar number 1, no problem. But suppose you follow scholar number 1, you have done research on. Another scholar comes and says, what scholar number 1 has said is wrong, I give you proof from Quran and Sahih Hadith. You check up the proof. If it is wrong, you reject him and follow scholar number 1. But if the proof that fourth scholar gave you, it is from Quran and Hadith, going against the opinion of scholar number 1, then you reject the fatwa of scholar number 1. So if, see, for example, I am there, when I hear something, what I speak in the talk, I do my research. But there's more knowledge in my head, in my brain, which I haven't checked up. But yet, I classify. For example, if I hear a statement from Sheikh Nasiruddin Albani, MashaAllah, who expired recently, according to me, is one of the greatest muhaddis of the recent times. So what he says, I follow on the face of it. Because I've checked up, he's a scholar, MashaAllah, following Quran and Sahih Hadith. But if someone gets me a fatwa against Nasiruddin Albani, if it's from Quran and Sunnah, I may reject the fatwa of Nasiruddin Albani. I mean, but I know, see, every human being can make mistakes. Imam Shafi made a mistake, Imam Abu Hanifa made a mistake, Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal made, Imam Malik made. So why can't Sheikh Nasiruddin Al-Albani make? He can make, but he belongs to the group of scholars which checks up on Quran and Hadith. So if someone gives a fatwa, a local person from here, and Nasiruddin Al-Albani, I'll believe Nasiruddin Al-Albani if I don't have time. But if I say in the lecture, I check it up. What I say in the lecture, I check up, because I'm responsible for that. But for my own knowledge, if I have to make opinion, I can't keep on checking every hadith. Difficult for a layman. So, but to classify which group of scholars I'm reading of.